look at this crazy fun fair in Bradford. This vlog's starting super late in the day and it's 6 p.m. Just left the office. I'm heading back into Leeds. The reason I'm vlogging is because I've got a lot to do this evening. The weather's super nice again. I definitely need to do a run. The girls work until 8 p.m. I've got some wedding invites to design. I've got 2 days worth of vlog to edit, which each one is about 6 hours worth of work. And I have some other stuff that I want to work on tonight if I can. The thing is, I want to get this vlog out. It just ends up being like an unsustainable amount of editing at the moment. So I'm doing my best to get as much done as I can in and outside of work hours and everything else that's going on. Hence tonight, I just wanted to vlog. It's going to be a short vlog, but it's going to be an intentional vlog. Lighting kind of sucks in here, so I know it's not a great picture, but my plan is to get home, do a quick run, maybe get 30 minutes or 40 minutes in there, and then apparently the sun sets at 7:50 tonight, so I'm going to do my best to do a run, get upstairs, film a great sunset time lapse, and then head on to, I'm probably going to sit on the roof. If I'm honest, I'm going to sit on the roof and I'm gonna do the wedding invites there and get the rest of the work done too. I might edit the vlog up there and I'm gonna set the GoPro up to film a nice time lapse. All right, hopefully it works out. So right now I'm going to do my best to go out there and beat my last time, which I forgot what it was, but it's in my app. Such nice weather to run in, and I'm super, super excited about getting out to run tonight. And then I'm going to head back, get on the rooftop, do a great time lapse, see what that looks like, and get rid of some of this workload. And just got a few thoughts like bubbling in my mind as well, so maybe I'll get some of those out too. Anyway, the sun's setting, I'm going to get out, do a great run, enjoy it, and then get back to do some work. Okay, just at the halfway point, 3K in, I don't know what it was, something like 14 minutes, maybe? Yeah, 14 minutes, something like that. So I'm going to head back now. I'm not sure I'll make it back in time for the sunset, because I reckon it's setting now. But I'm going to head back and hopefully catch it. Okay, so that was 6K done in 30 minutes and 26 seconds, which I think is my best time I've ever done. I think, especially this year, since I started running again this year, I think since the beginning of the year, I started probably 2 weeks ago. The first run was like 2K and was a nightmare, really difficult. So over the last 2 weeks, it's been amazing to see the progress of like getting up to 6K. I feel really good about it. This is a great result. I went up to the rooftop, made it to the rooftop, but only just caught the very end of the sunset, which is pretty frustrating because it was a good sunset. You saw the sunset, it was nice. Did you see it? Or am I going to put it after I've said this or before? The run made me think a lot about stuff that's just bubbling in my mind a little bit. I wanted to just talk about this question that was on my mind a lot today. What do you do when you don't know what to do next? The little bit of running that I've been doing recently, I'm always trying to push myself to achieve something a little bit more than what I did last time. Part of that's an issue because I'm always overdoing it, running way too much and injuring myself. There's always at the core of that, which is at the core of everyone, is just this idea of what should I do next? What's my next step? How do I keep moving forward? And one of the things I think people struggle with, because I've struggled with it myself, is that when you're considering what to do next, you can easily allow the fear of what to do next to become paralysis to you. Because of that fear, you don't move forward into what you could do next, and you end up being stuck in what you're doing, and it can be such a frustrating thing. And I've done a lot of frustration with stuff like that. So much so today I was thinking a lot about it, and it was on my mind, and I wanted to at least just address it a little bit in this short vlog. There's always been levels of frustration with it, and it's always been a difficult thing to transition and journey. But ultimately, I think there's things that we can do in the process. And one of the first things that I think is important to do is just remind yourself where you've come from. It's so easy to forget that you've actually come a long way. Maybe you weren't working at all, and now you're just a barista at Starbucks, and you feel like that's a frustrating thing. But if you remind yourself where you've come from and how far you've come, you'll realize even if you have only moved an inch, you've moved an inch, and an inch is progress, and progress is a great motivator. Second thing I'd say, which I found really important, is to remind yourself where you're going. If you know that you're going somewhere, if you know that you've got a future in something, if you know that you're moving towards a goal, it's a lot easier to put up with the stuff in the middle of it. The third thing to do really is to remind yourself that probably the most important factor in growth and in moving forward and in changing and developing is time. Time plays a major role in a lot of stuff. Eventually kids will learn how to speak, trees will grow, summer will come around. And the most important factor in all of that really, yes, there's other things involved like watering seed, like teaching a kid to talk, but ultimately time plays a big part in all of that stuff. And I think it's really important just to do what you can do, but allow Father Time to just play his role and do the best he can in just making some stuff come to be. I just wanted to say to someone that if you are considering a next step, if there is something else or what to do next, remind yourself that you've come so far already. Keep your mind focused and remember that you are going somewhere, and then allow time to play its role. Do what you're doing right now with a good attitude. Ultimately, you'll get that next step. That next step will come along. That next step is less of a thing to worry about. The attitude with which you handle today is actually way more important than what that next step is. And if you can get that settled today, it makes the transition of that a lot easier. That's enough of the deep philosophical stuff. I've done the wedding invites, I captured the time, that was great. So now I've just got to edit what was 2 days worth of vlogs is now 3 days because of this.